Hey guys, Kim here, and you are tuned into Kim E, the Diabetes MP. Today we are going to tackle the Don phenomenon. Now this phenomenon is kind of confused at time with another phenomenon called the SOMOGYI effect. Today we're going to talk about the Don phenomenon, but next week we're going to go into the SOMOGYI effect. Before we get into this phenomenon, I would like to ask if you can go ahead and subscribe, ding that notification bell, share this video with anyone that you feel that could benefit from this video. And without further ado, let's get into it. Now, what is the Don phenomenon? Now, simply put, it's basically having high readings of blood sugar, blood glucose in the morning. And now this is something that is not going to happen just one time, but it's something that happens consistently, okay? And we really want to make sure that it's something that's consistent because that allows us to see that it's an ongoing situation. Now we know that our blood sugars can be manipulated. Your patient may just have had a weekend full of eating all the foods that they want. Maybe they went to a wedding, maybe they went to a birthday party, and that is why they woke up on Monday and had high blood sugars. What we're looking for with the Don phenomenon are consistent blood sugars that are elevated, okay? Now, you may have your patient come in and one of their complaints could be something as simple as, you know what, doc or nurse practitioner, I take my medicine as I should. I eat a good balanced meal. And all throughout the day, my blood sugars are great. They're normal. It's just when I get up in the morning, it's really high. And I don't understand it because I took my insulin or I took my medicine as I was supposed to. It's always that morning blood sugar that's high. That's when you would start to say, I wonder if I got some little Don phenomenon going on. Now, a reason why we would really need to dig deeper when we have this complaint from our patients is that if a person is having elevated blood sugars on a regular basis, that increases their risk for complications. Now, I covered complications in many videos earlier in the year, and I'll link those videos down in the description box. I also went over patient education with patients when it comes to complications, and I'll link that down in the box as well. But you want to make sure that we are always trying to prevent any complications from coming up. So why does the Don phenomenon occur? Why does it happen? Okay. Now I'll let you in on a little secret. To a certain extent, all of us experience different levels of the Don phenomenon. Whether you have diabetes or you don't have diabetes, we all have the same mechanism that is working in our body. Now, what happens is in the wee hours of the morning, hence the word dawn, okay, around 2 or 3 o'clock all the way to about 6 to 8 o'clock in the morning, our bodies release different hormones, okay? These hormones, growth hormone, cortisol, epinephrine, glucagon. Now, take note of what I just mentioned. Think about those hormones. Those hormones, especially like your growth hormone, is antagonistic to insulin, okay? Now, for the normal person, our body has the normal response and releases more insulin. Our bodies don't have any insulin resistance, and quickly our body compensates and our blood sugar goes back down. But for the diabetic, we already know there's some insulin resistance going on. Maybe there's some liver dumping of glucose in the bloodstream. And we already know that the diabetic cannot normalize their blood glucose level. So you take a phenomenon that happens in everyone and you put a person who cannot regulate their blood glucose level and you have hyperglycemia. That is why that early in the morning you have high blood sugar. You have a high reading of your blood glucose. So one last thing I want to mention in this section before we move on is the reason why these hormones are released, okay? And especially why they're released early in the morning. Now, like I mentioned, the release starts about 2, 3 o'clock, and then they kind of tear off and drop down about 6 to 8 o'clock. Now, what time is that? That typically is the time when we're going to start getting up. So these hormones are released in our sleep, wake cycle. So to kind of get us up and going, okay? They're preparing the body to get ready to get up, okay? So if you think about what these hormones are, they're getting us riled up so we'll be able to get up and get ready to go on our day. And that is the reason why you'll see this and why it's so normal to see this in everybody, because this literally is really our body's way of waking us up and preparing our body to wake up. Now, how do you detect the dawn phenomenon and how do you differentiate it from the SOMOGYI effect? Okay. Now, it's a very simple thing. You as the provider would want your patient to take their blood sugar early in the morning around 2 or 3 o'clock when those hormones are starting to be released, okay? And you want them to do this over a series of days, okay? Like again, we're not looking for this one-time thing. We're looking for the trend. Are you typically high consistently early in the morning around the same time? We're looking at trends, okay? Now, you can do this by having them get up in the morning and to actually take it themselves manually, or you can hook them up briefly to a continuous glucose monitoring if you have access to that, because then the patient can sleep, the results can be sent to your office, or they can bring, you know, however you have it set up, they can bring the machine in over a course of days and you can read the readings and you can see it, and that doesn't disrupt their sleep. But what we're looking for is if you notice that these blood sugars are high or if they're normal around that time, it's likely dawn phenomenon, okay? Now, how would you treat this? How would you address it? Now, it goes without saying, okay, we always have to ask our patients, are you taking your medications regularly? And are you eating regular, well-balanced meals? It's a good time for education and getting your history on them. We can never assume that people are doing all of the things that they're supposed to do. You know, in a perfect world, yes, but we don't live in a perfect world. So you have to first ask those very obvious questions. Are you taking your medicines regularly? Have you been taking it at the same time every day? Has there been a change in when you have taken your medicine? Are you taking all of your medicines? You need to ask those questions. You want to inquire about what kind of foods they're eating in the evening, because it could be that they've been having a lot of fatty foods. Maybe they have had a lot of foods high in carbs, and you know, maybe that is the reason why they're having this spike early in the morning. But you want to start there first. After you do that and you see that everything is still the same and they're still spiking high, you may want to consider increasing the medication dosage of the evening medications. If they're on insulin, increasing the insulin. If they're on just orals, maybe increasing the dosage there in the evening to really combat that high blood sugar. You even may want to even consider moving that time later, closer to bedtime and not maybe at dinner time, okay? Maybe they need a little bit more coverage later on in the morning. So let's push the medicine back. You may even want them to eat dinner earlier, okay? So when their carbs are high, the medicine is working when the carbs are high. You may even advise them to avoid carbs at bedtime. So don't eat the carbs close to bedtime. You know, have your meal earlier, eat beforehand. And then also something else that you can advise them to do is that after dinner, maybe having some light activity, maybe go for a walk, maybe do some yoga, something like that, that can really stimulate that insulin production for them. So their body is working for them as the medications are working for them as well. Okay, guys, that's all I have for you. I hope that you learned something about the dawn phenomenon. I know that all of us, if you are a nurse, I remember learning about this in undergrad, but one of the things that I feel as nurse practitioners that really should benefit us is knowing the why behind why do these things occur and what do we need to do and why do we do the things that we do. To me, I feel like that will help you remember these conditions a whole lot better, and it will be kind of more so second nature in a sense. So I hope you guys appreciate that. Now, remember, we did talk about dawn phenomenon today, but next week we're going to talk about the SOMOGYI effect, and we're going to really compare the two. If you want to, I have put together a little cheat sheet, a little visual chart for you that compares the two, the dawn phenomenon and the SOMOGYI effect. If you're interested in that, feel free to click the link in the description box and you can have at it. It's all free. If you have not, go ahead and subscribe, ding the notification bell so you do not miss an upload. If you like my teaching style, you might as well join the family, okay? Now, you have been sitting here with Kim E, the Diabetes MP, but I do have to leave you with one last thing that we must always remember. Let us never, ever, ever, ever leave a nurse behind. Bye-bye.